follow Ruben Studdard as the next American Idol. Well, I'll tell you what, it's not going to be Danny Parker from Atlanta.
Crazy.
It's probably not going to be either of the twins from New York.
Don't worry, baby, just call my name.
Just when I thought it couldn't get any worse.
That? And it's definitely not going to be Fook Ling Lee from Houston.
Where his head used to lay.
Fook Ling, you are one of the worst singers I've ever heard in my life. And I'm not exaggerating.
But there is real talent out there. We know it. And tonight, the search continues in L.A. and San Francisco.
You treated me kind.
This is American Idol. Los Angeles, fourth stop on our nationwide tour. Ironically, the home of the stars is not a great town for American Idol talent. But Cali is the home of hope, and a staggering 10,000 people brought their game to the first round of auditions at the Rose Bowl.
I'm the next American Idol.
I am the next American Idol. What's up, man?
I'm the next American Idol. Thank you very much.
And to stand any chance of being the next American Idol, you had to camp out. In line, on the ground. It was going to be a long wait. Over at Camp Diva, there was no time for sleep.
It's like 4 in the morning. We have been up, seriously, for like 3 days straight, and we just feel like jittery.
Sleeping
like
on the street, we smell so good.
Preparation was everything, and the girls did their best to impress under siege conditions. But for some, the street was no place to glamorize, and with no electricity in the ladies' room, there was the last resort. In with the boys.
It is very early in the morning here in Los Angeles. They have been waiting for days. Many of them have camped out for 2 or 3 nights. And we're about to let them in so they can audition to be the next American Idol. Welcome to American Idol 3. Good luck.
As the big day finally arrived, the contestants filed into the stadium and the cattle call auditions began.
Okay, this is it.
When I fall in love,
it will be fun.
A long, painful process, but for the lucky few to make it through to the judges, it was worth every single second.
Oh, wow!
This is so fabulous. I'm excited.
Then came the real test in front of the people that mattered most.
Hollywood, don't disappoint me. We need a Hollywood winner.
This was going to be a big day, but nevertheless, Simon was, as ever, fashionably late.
An extra long bath this morning? You realize you're
Hi,
late.
Charles.
You realize you're late.
How are you?
You realize how late you are?
How are you, Mike?
You realize how disrespectful that is to the entire crew? It makes you look good?
Well, it's embarrassing. That man has no shame. But he did have a tough job that day because Paula was still under the weather from Houston. And from the word go, that talent was enough to make anybody feel bad.
Buddy, you're a boy, make a big noise, playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday. You got blood on your face, you big disgrace, kicking your kind all over the place, screaming, we will rock you, rock you.
When the moon is in the supper house, and you turn a line with Mars.
Blue moon, blue moon. So sorry, I'm nervous. Blue moon, you saw me standing alone, without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own. Blue moon.
It's a note.
It's a note. Thank you. Thank you.
If I'm being honest, by the time I hit Los Angeles, I was in a bad mood, Randy was in a bad mood, and I think it showed.
Simon in a bad mood? Never. But 17-year-old Nicole Crook was ready for anything with a good luck kiss from her 7-month-old son.
So you ready for this?
Yeah, I am.
So it says you're a really good cook.
No.
No?
No, I'm the only Italian in my family that can't cook.
But you can sing. You can sing, right?
I can sing.
All right, what are you going to sing?
Fever.
Go for it. I like that song.
Never knew how much I loved you. Never knew how much I cared. When you put your arms around me, I get a fever that's so hard to bear. You give me fever. When you kiss me, fever. When you hold me tight, fever. In the morning, fever all through the night.
Well, Nicole, cooking is not your problem. That was terrible.
Really?
Oh, dreadful. Dreadful. Nothing. There was nothing there. How do you think you did, Nicole?
I wish it could have been better for you guys, but I honestly think that I'm good, and...
You're not.
Well, that's fine. I'm glad that you think that, but that's your opinion. It's not mine.
Why are you glad?
Because it's your opinion, and honestly, it doesn't matter to me what you think. I mean, you've been mean, basically, to a lot of people, so
no, I think we're being honest, Nicole. I mean, for somebody like yourself who comes in to enter a competition called American Idol...
Oh, yeah.
You know the people, the standard has won before, and you come in and do a horrendous rendition of Fever. What else can we say other than...
Yeah, it's terrible.
You're terrible.
It was that bad?
It was that bad.
Really bad.
Yeah.
Hearing you sing there, I think, like, she shouldn't ever sing again. It was that bad.
Are you serious?
Yeah, serious.
It was that bad.
Absolutely serious.
Oh, wow.
I'd brush
up on
your cooking.
I honestly think I was that bad.
Why did you cry? Why are you listening to these morons?
I know it's not the fact I didn't make it. I don't care. I didn't make it. This is not by me. It's the fact that they said I... It just hurt me. It was insulting. I mean, I dedicate my time to come here and give up time with him to come here. And I don't think I sing that bad. It's stupid. I gave up 2 days with him in the Rose Bowl to be here.
Honey.
And like hundreds and hundreds of dollars to be here.
Honey, go.
Let's go.
Nicole wasn't the only casualty that day. Without Paula to hold them back, Randy and Simon weren't pulling any punches, and our contestants felt every blow.
They were just horrible.
You remind me of somebody when you're at a party and someone's had a few drinks right at the end, attempts to sing something, and then you're thrown out the house. Okay, Neva. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear.
Wow.
Dreadful. Terrible.
I think the dancing was bad too.
You have absolutely no charisma and no star quality at all.
Simon doesn't like young girls. That's your problem, Simon.
He said I was musical wallpaper.
No, you're not even close to being good enough.
You're gonna make it. You're gonna make it. They don't count anyway.
Can I do something else?
Leave.
All right. Like this competition has turned into a joke.
Something had to give.
Straight up.
LA needed to come up with the goods and fast. Stay with us as thankfully the Hollywood magic begins. The LA auditions are underway, and so far the local talent has yet to make an impression. The contestants were starting to get spooked.
It's kind of depressing having nobody go yet.
Yeah.
Nobody is going to Hollywood yet.
Like, out of all the people.
Yeah, a little nervous about that.
I know. No one's made it so far.
Nobody?
Not one person's gotten through.
Oh.
Randy and Simon were worried that we may have another Houston on our hands. But not if Bao Viet had anything to do with it. His parents escaped from Indochina to realize the American dream. Now he may just do that.
My wife and I learned here. As Indo-Chinese refugees, we have nothing. And we hope the first generation will do something with America. Because America gave us a lot of opportunity, but because we came here, it's too late to make that opportunity. So my son gonna make it.
Do you believe you're a star?
Actually, I believe myself as a businessman. I want to make myself a lot of money and a lot of you a lot of money.
With what?
With my voice, my talent.
Yeah?
Mm. Yeah.
And what are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing Lately by Stevie Wonder.
Off you go.
Oh, I'm a man of many wishes. Hope my premonition misses. But what I really feel, my eyes won't let me hide. 'Cause they always start to cry. 'Cause this time could mean goodbye.
Very good.
Mm.
Very good.
Wow.
Good voice.
Wow.
Pure.
Mm.
Randy?
Definitely. I think you got a really good voice, dude. I was
so
impressed.
Yes or no?
Definitely.
You're through.
Welcome to Hollywood, baby.
Thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
What's up, baby? Yeah. What's up? What's up, baby? Yeah. Yeah. What's up, second guy? What's up, baby? Second guy. Okay, I wrinkled this up. 2-3-2-3. Representing my mom and dad here, both people. 1980. Went on a boat here for 2 weeks. Ate with rats and stuff, man. Yeah, that's deep love, man.
Balviette was good, and that's the point I thought maybe this is a turning point in the day.
I wanna wake up in the city that never sleeps and find I'm king of the hill, top of the list, and number one.
It's been a long process for Randy and Simon. Only six people have been taken through. But the final contestant of the day, Matt Rogers, was in the zone.
Yeah, I think I'm the next American Idol for a few reasons. First of all, I'm American. Second of all, I think I have the baby face here to get kind of like the younger viewers. I also have the receding hairline to get, the older viewers. Nice tiny waist for the skinny people. And kind of like a chubby figure, for the not so slim people.
He's my baby brother. He's a blockhead. He's a football player with an unbelievable voice. That's pretty rare,
Go, Matt! Let's go!
How you doing?
What's going down, man?
You guys excited? I'm the last guy.
Yeah!
I know you guys are fired up. I know you guys are burned out. So I'm going to bring something. I'm going to bring some flavor, some smiles, some personality, something you guys probably have not seen today. I'm an ex-ball player. I was at the University of Washington Rose Bowl, so.
Oh, get down.
Offensive line. I was 340, but I'm trying to lose some weight for the ladies. So
all right, get down. Get down. All right, so what are you going to sing for us?
I'm going to sing James Ingram, Just Once.
Off you go.
Just once, can we figure out what we keep doing wrong? Why we never last for very long? What are we doing wrong? Just once, can we find a way to finally make it right? Make the magic last for more than just one night.
Thank you. Big man, big voice.
Big man, big voice, big opportunity.
I say yes.
Football. One down.
Thank you very much, sir.
Matthew, I have some news for you.
Yes.
We are going to see you in Hollywood.
Yeah!
Yeah, baby, yeah, woo! Yeah.
Come on!
Last, but by no means least, Randy and Simon are going to be just as tough tomorrow. Can the talent take it? It's day two of the LA auditions. Paula is still sick, and Simon and Randy are still smarting from the slim pickings of yesterday's talent. From the outset, today looked like it was going to be just as much of a struggle.
You can reach me by trail away. You can reach me on a airplane. You can reach me, reach your mind.
Tomomi, as you can tell probably by now, was probably just a one-off, right? Because, we really started worrying when she said, I can reach you by hairy plane. What is a hairy plane? Having a little problem there, Tomomi. but listen, Jasmine Ortega, I really think you're going to like this next one.
It means so much to me because I wouldn't think I would come here and, people give me a chance. But I'm just going to go in there and show them what I can do. And hopefully they'll like me for who I am, not, outside. Look at me from the inside.
Jasmine has done more things than her other sisters. Her other older sisters tried out for cheerleading. they never made it. When Jasmine told me she was going to try cheerleading, I was like, Jasmine, you're not going to make it. She proved me wrong. She made it.
Come on, Jasmine.
Hello, Jasmine.
How are you, sweetheart?
Good, thank you very much.
Welcome, welcome.
Why are you here, Jasmine?
Because I would love to be the next American Idol.
Why?
Because I am different, and I love to sing, and I love people, and I just love performing. I love it all.
Cool.
Have you auditioned before?
No, this is my first time.
Wow.
You nervous?
Very nervous.
Okay. And what are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing I Turn to You by Christina Aguilera.
Off you go.
When my world is going crazy, you can turn it all around, and when I'm down, you're there, pushing me to the top. You're always there, giving me all you've got, for a shield from the storm, for a friend, for a love to keep me safe.
You're very good.
Thank you.
But you know that. Yes or no?
That's a yes.
Jasmine, we will see you in Hollywood. Congratulations.
Yeah, Jasmine.
Oh, my God.
Work it out, Jasmine. Work it out. Work it out.
Bye, sweetheart.
Simon was so nice, and oh my God, I seriously can't believe this.
Petite can be powerful. As Jasmine moves forward to Hollywood, Drea Hancock wants to take a step back.
I want to try and bring it back to what it used to be. I want them to see me as, you know what, this is somebody who represents America, the American Idol.
If you won this competition, what would you do with the money?
You know what, I've been wanting the Thunderbird, but I want it in pink. Obviously, it's my favorite color. And I think that's what I'll do. I'll buy that first.
That was an honest answer. I like you.
A Ford Thunderbird.
The old one, because it looks very retro. And I love the retro, the 50s
yeah,
and
you're
the 60s.
Very 50s. Yeah.
And so I just think, you know what? I'd be just so cute in my little convertible. So that's
it. You could have a little pink chihuahua.
Yeah.
Okay.
No,
what are you going to sing?
Almost Like Being in Love.
Good. Off you go.
Okay. What a day this has been. What a rare mood I'm in. Why, it's almost like being in love. There's a smile on my face for the whole human race. Why, it's almost like being in love. Oh, the music of life seems to be like a bell that is ringing just for me. And from the way that I feel when that bell starts to peal, I would swear I was falling, swear I was falling. Why, it's almost like being in love.
Thank you. I thought you were very good.
Thank you.
You're different.
Thank you.
You're just perfect the way you look.
Thank you.
I have no idea what will happen to you in the next round, but I'm going to say yes. Randy?
Very good voice. I mean, very interesting. I don't know either. I don't know how far she'll go, but I like you too. There's something very different about you that's interesting.
Good. That's yeah. Exactly what I was looking
no,
for.
No, you were listening. You're different. You stand out. That's the great thing. That's why you're going through. You're through. Congratulations.
Welcome to Hollywood.
Yay! So, the girls are doing well. How will the boys do? Rodrigo Cortez, who looked every inch an idol, was hoping for a good start.
Isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Less than 1 minute old. I never thought through love we'd be making one as lovely as she. But isn't she lovely, made from love?
Not bad.
What do you think, Carl?
Not bad.
Is it good enough?
It's great enough. To you guys.
It was okay.
You know what, Simon? Okay is better than what I was expecting, and what I want to do, I want to give America every person out there. I want to reach every single person out there. I can't do that by myself on my own two feet. My job is to put a smile on everybody's face. Everybody's face.
What would you do if you won and I gave you $1 million? What would you do with the money?
What would I do with the money? I have $1 million. I'd give about $100,000 to charity, put about $2,000 to invest, make a little bit more money in that, put some more into charity, and just keep it growing.
Okay, it's a note. Thank you.
Thank you.
No. Listen.
Yes. It's a note. Rodrigo, I'm really short of time. I've got to go. Honestly, it's a note.
I have to go.
Off you go.
Thank you, dude.
I got sunshine.
Rodrigo.
You can sing on your way out, though.
Out you go.
She said, okay. That is good. That it's good, and then one question turns everything around, you know? And I know I could do it. I know I can. It's just, I can do it. I swear to you guys, I'm giving you my word here.
That's going to be killing me, that little question. I want to be pondering that for the rest of my life. When I do have $1 million, I want to say, Simon, here's your million. Put it in your face.
So, no go for Rodrigo, but he was certainly not the only guy to get the bad news in L.A. that day. By 4 o'clock in the afternoon, not a single one had made it.
I either said no or I respect their decision.
Paula, girl, where are you? No guys have been picked because you're not here. You're not here. You're not here.
The Los Angeles sun is beating down as the contestants wait for their shot in front of Randy and Simon. But a pattern was starting to emerge. No guys were making it. Just lots of very happy young ladies.
Oh, sure.
Yes, I did hear that there were lots and lots of girls getting through. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but I just find it a little bit odd that since I wasn't there to keep my boys on a leash, they went crazy.
Get you through.
Okay, welcome to Hollywood.
You are coming through to the next round.
Thank you.
You're through.
Thank you.
Welcome to Hollywood.
Thank you.
Paula, rubbish. We put the girls through because they were talented. The guys didn't get through because they were dreadful.
Tell me, how am I supposed to live without you? Now that I've been loving you so long.
Stop.
Oh, yes. Why? What? No, just go. I've got nothing else to say.
Cause baby, there ain't no mountain high enough, and no valley low enough, and no river wide enough to keep me from getting to you. Don't you know that there?
I guess that's a no, then.
They haven't let any guys through so far. Not one guy has made it from Los Angeles. Are you going to be the first guy today?
Maybe.
Yeah?
Yeah.
There you go. See, I mean, we want to believe it. We need some male power. I'm going to be the first guy today, if not the first, the second, if not the second, the third, if not the third, the fourth. Right.
How you doing today, Randy?
What's up, baby?
How you doing, Gita?
Great guys.
Two great guys.
You've left 15 women through, no men?
Well, you might change that, Gita.
Hey, I'm about to change that.
You haven't sat in the audition room, Gita.
Go for it.
We belong together. And you know that, right?
Stop.
It's a no, Gita. No.
Hold on. Gita.
It's a no. Yes, sir. Not good enough, dude. Sorry.
Please, man.
Gita, don't please. It wasn't good enough.
Not good enough, dude.
Well, just tell me what is wrong with it.
It's
I'm telling you, man, that's a group song. Let me sing
Gita,
something.
It's a no.
Let
just vocally, something. Dude. You're not strong enough. We're trying to find the best, though.
It's a no. Sorry.
You can sing. Trust. Take that. You can sing, but you need a lot more work, dude.
Sorry. All right. See ya.
But Gita was so sure, and so is Chef Jeffrey Dingle.
Yes, I am the next American Idol because I have the talent, the confidence, the passion, and the drive that goes along with it.
And aside from that, also because I want to be an inspiration to all the aspiring performers out there that dreams do come true as long as you stick to it.
Your name is Jeffrey Dingle.
That is correct.
Okay, Jeffrey Dingle, what are you going to sing for us?
I'll be singing Desperado.
Off you go, one of my favorite songs of all time.
Desperado, why don't you come to your senses? Come down from your fences. Open the gate. It may be raining, 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 but there's a rainbow above you. You'd better let somebody love you before it's too late. Whoa.
Good. Actually, you did a good arrangement on that song.
Thank you.
As well.
Thank you very much.
Nice. Good. Randy.
Good looking guy. Thank nice voice.
Much. Thank you.
As the judges decided, Gito nursed a bruised ego.
They said I could sing, but I wasn't there yet. I'm only 19. It's all right, though. I'm not going anywhere, and y'all going to regret it. That's all I know, man. I ain't coming back to American Idol because they ain't even real. I'm going to be the best you ever seen. Watch.
Yeah, I say let's do it.
Well done. You're through.
Thank you very much.
See you in Hollywood, dude.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good. Well done. Off you go.
You're going to regret it. Randy and Simon, you're going to regret it because you know you passed up a good offer. My dad?
Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah!
The men are representing.
Oh, what's up, honey?
This is real.
It's unbelievable. I don't know what they're looking for. They're obviously not looking for an R&B superstar. They're looking for a pop icon. That must be what the show is about.
It's nonsense. Okay? I think it's nonsense. I think Randy and Bob Simon sort of... I'm not going to curse, but it's nonsense. Simon, you robbed my son. Randy, you robbed my son. I wish Paulo was here. Bye.
So, Jeffrey is the first boy through. Finally, the guys fight back, making a total of 25 through to round two. Stay with us for the return of Paula Abdul. And the best...
I've done all right up till now.
And the worst...
I hear the father dip is gonna blow the blue.
From San Francisco. San Francisco. Hippie hangout of the 60s. Perennially cool and eclectic. The perfect place to welcome back Paula Abdul.
We're looking for... great talent. We hear there's some awesome talent.
Of course, it was wasted on Jackson and Cal.
It's so different from everywhere else we've been.
Yeah, it's another city.
American Idol now in the city of San Francisco. This is a very unique, eclectic city. So we expect to see a mixed variety of talent.
Hey, yeah, we're here looking for the next big thing in music.
Oh, you're going to find it here.
I'm going to find it, aren't I?
Yes,
well, are we going to find it? Let's find out.
My name is Mike. I'm from San Francisco, California. I'm from here, and I have gusto.
Come on, babe, why won't we paint the town? And all that jazz, I hear that father dip is gonna blow the blues. And all that jazz, oh, I'm gonna shimmy till my garters break. And all that jazz, show her where to park her girdle. Oh, her baby's love her curdle.
All right, Michael, oh, that was absolutely ghastly. From start, middle, finish.
Oh, Michael.
Is that
awful?
Really bad. It wasn't.
It was.
It wasn't good.
It terrible.
Wasn't good.
You think I'm really bad?
Yes. Yeah.
Seriously?
Absolutely.
You know you're bad, though, right?
I don't think so.
Well, let me reassure you, you are terrible. Honestly, Michael, I mean, you can't sing.
Never know how much I love you. never know how much I care.
Okay, you proved your point. You really can't sing.
Yeah, we don't care.
Michael, it's a no. Out
you go. Well, Michael, you have great passion, though. It was fun.
Okay, off you go.
It's the third season of American Idol and the first time we brought the show to San Francisco. But for many people, not the first time they've tried out to be on the show. I'm talking about the repeaters. Those who just don't get the fact that you only get one shot to make it in this business. Actually, I didn't feel that. Can we do it one more time?
I went to LA and I didn't even make it past the first audition.
This is actually my third time auditioning for something like this. I auditioned the second season and in LA this season.
I've tried out before in Los Angeles, and they said, sorry, we're not really looking for that right now. So I said, okay, I gotta find what they're looking for because I need what they're looking for so I can be on the show. I had hair down to here, and I was in the shower going, something needs to change, something needs to change. Snip, 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 dye, and here I am.
Prison guard Victoria Elliott not only changed her look for her second shot, but brought along her best friend and advisor, Jack.
What are you most nervous about here? Seeing Simon in there?
I'm most nervous? No.
No?
No, 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 this guy.
You're nervous?
Now you think Simon's bad? Oh my God, 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, 365 days
I'm
a year.
Not that
Simon
bad.
Only does it what? For this.
I don't, Sir Jack is worse than Simon? Yes.
I train her for that.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Then he was just walking down the street saying, I do, I did he done, did he do? Snapping his fingers and shuffling his feet. Saying, do I did he don't, did he do? He looked good, he looked fine. He looked good, he looked fine. Oh, I almost lost my mind.
Randy.
Wow, I don't even know what to say.
Funny enough, nor do I.
Yeah,
affected.
Yes, yeah, so affected, so like out of some other time era. I don't even know what's going on.
It sounds as if you weren't opening your mouth as well.
Yeah, like you're singing like.
Do you want me to sing another song?
No, I think we've got the gist here.
Yeah.
Vicky. Randy, yes or no?
No, I have to say no. I mean, I didn't really get it.
Okay.
Bit cabaret like.
Oh, okay.
Not for this competition. I'm going to have to pass on you.
I totally agree. You look and sound cabaret, not for us. So it's a no.
Okay.
Thank you, though.
Okay, thanks.
Bye-bye. Same way.
What was that?
I don't know. Not so good. No.
No?
No.
No. No.
No.
No.
I'm pissed.
I'm really pissed.
Victory was defeated, but Jack was mad.
They didn't get it. They didn't get it. It's your job to make sure they get it. It's your job. It's your destiny. It's your life.
I told somebody that I wanted to go back in there.
You make it happen.
I am making it happen. I'm telling you to sit down and wait, and we can wait till the end of the thing, and we can do it.
You can wait.
Wound up by Jack, Victoria went from producer to producer asking for a second audition with no luck. As they formulated a different approach, they were intercepted by the venue's security.
You've asked several times, they're asking you to leave, you need to leave. Okay, you've had several opportunities, you've asked several different people, so we could have you leave, we'd appreciate it.
Well, sing. Sing, we'll leave. Sing, okay. Yeah. Start singing anyways.
Yeah, when start. I fall in love, it will be forever.
You know where to place her.
Cause I'll never fall in love. And the moment you can feel that, you feel that way too.
You don't fit in the show.
I will.
We don't have a
fall
in
love with you. And that's what you missed out on, Miss Cabaret Singer. Does that sound like a cabaret singer to you? I don't think so.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Coming up, we meet smoking hot cheerleader Katie Weber. But there's nothing to cheer about when William Hung enters the room.
She bangs! She bangs! Oh, baby! But she moves! She moves!
The thing any talented performer needs is confidence.
This is Vanessa Lucero, your next American Idol.
I'm coming to join you, Ruben!
And it was certainly in no short supply in San Francisco.
I'm the next American Idol!
I'm the next American Idol!
With all that confidence, we were hoping for a gold rush of yellow tickets. But what we mostly got was straight out of Central Casting.
Come up to San Francisco, and of course, you run into cowboys.
A car salesman and...
I like to surf, and I like smoothies.
I feel like I belong on the stage.
I can definitely move well and look at the camera and smile and have a good time.
I can do it all.
I'm going to give you style and all of me.
You're going to be great.
I am. I know I am.
Hello. Kenneth Fitzgerald.
That's me.
How you doing?
Great. How are you?
You're barefoot.
Let me guess. You like surfing.
How you doing?
Howdy.
Howdy.
Stand on the D right there.
Blind.
Joshua, what's up, man?
It is an honor to meet you all.
Waiting in sync for us today.
Drops of Jupiter by Train.
Partridge Family, I Think I Love You.
Okay.
I'm going to sing Ain't Going Down Till the Sun Comes Up by Garth Brooks.
All right, go for it.
You ready?
Now that she's back in the atmosphere with drops of Jupiter in her hair.
I think I love you, so what am I so afraid of?
I ain't going down till the sun comes up. I ain't giving in till they get enough.
As a singer, you are a brilliant car salesman. Aaron, let me put it in terms you'll understand. That was a musical wipeout.
Oh, no.
Stop.
Stop it.
Joshua, stop, please.
I'm sorry.
No, this is not good enough.
Well, what is?
You leaving.
If I could do it again, that would be great, but I know you only get one shot at this, and that's life.
I gave it my all. I don't know what happened. They didn't like me, I guess.
That guy can shove it. That's all I have to say.
Well, charming, but there were plenty of people in San Francisco who merited their confidence.
And the sound of the rain against my window pane. It's slowly driving me insane. Since you went away, don't you know I sit around
with of course, the inevitable exceptions.
I surrender.
So do we.
But with the judges' surrender to the charms of cheerleader Katie Webber,
clock strikes upon the hour and the sun begins to fade. Soon enough time I'll figure out how to chase my blues away. I've done all right up till now. It's the light of day that shows me how. And when the night falls, my lonely heart calls. Oh, I want to dance with somebody.
Good job. Randy?
Wow. Well, that song definitely was good. I mean, I'm happy you did that. Cute girl, great personality.
I think, Catherine, you're one of those girls who's probably good at most things you apply yourself to. But without being
what
great.
What does that mean?
Well, you know, look, Kinga can't win this competition, but actually I could see you, funny enough, maybe even making the top 10.
Yeah. Aww. That was very nice.
That
means
nice.
He says yes, and I say yes, and we all say yes, and you're going,
welcome to Hollywood, yeah! A cheer, yeah!
We always knew in our search for the next Ruben Studdard, we'd run across the next Keith, and we did here in San Francisco. This time, he was hung.
I grew up in Los Angeles, California. Originally born from Hong Kong, so I've been here in the United States for 10 years. And I'm currently studying at UC Berkeley right now. But it's kind of odd, like, why I chose to even audition in the first place. Because my major is civil engineering, which is not related to music. But I really like music. I want to make music my living.
Talk to me, tell me your name. You blow me off like it's all the same. You lit it fierce and I'm ticking away like a bomb. Yeah, baby. Talk to me. Tell me your sign. You're switching sides like a Gemini. You're playing games and now you're hitting my heart like a drum. Yeah, baby. She bangs. She bangs. Oh, baby. When she moves, she moves. I go crazy cause she looks like a fly, but she stings like a bee. Like every girl in history. She bangs, she bangs.
Thank
I'm
you.
Wasted by the way
Thank
she...
Thank you.
Thank
can't sing, you can't dance, so what do you want me to say?
I already gave my best, and I have no regrets at all.
Good for you.
That's good. That's good.
That's the best attitude yet.
You know, I have no professional training of singing
no.
or dancing, so.
Well, there's the surprise of the century.
William, you're the best. You're the best.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, William.
Okay. Thank you, William.
Thank you.
So William would have to bang somewhere other than Hollywood. But it was better news for 10 others in San Francisco that day. Round 2 was waiting. Tomorrow night, we head to Hawaii, where the talent reminded us of a soap opera. Tune in for the big, the bold, and the beautiful, which was a welcome change from the good, the bad, and the ugly.